My name is Dr. Weatherhead and I'm a consultant dermatologist in Newcastle. And in this video, we cover useful information about adalimumab specifically. This is a class of biologic called an anti-TNF, and it's used for a number of inflammatory conditions, including psoriasis, psoriatic arthritis, hidradenitis suppurativa, rheumatoid arthritis, and Crohn's disease. Please make sure you also watch the introduction to biologics video that accompanies this for more general information. Adalimumab normally takes between 3 and 12 weeks to start helping the skin, and it can be highly effective even in patients who failed other treatments such as methotrexate. Adalimumab is available as either a pre-filled syringe or a pre-filled pen device, which automatically injects the drug under the skin, and you'll be shown how to inject yourself with this. It's easy to do, even if you're squeamish. Typically, the injection can be given into the skin of the stomach, the thighs, or the upper outer arms. And it's important that you store your adalimumab in the fridge at temperatures between 2 and 8 degrees. If you're traveling with your injection, for example, if you're going on holiday, take a cool bag with ice packs in to keep it cool at that temperature. And if you do have travel plans and you're going abroad, make sure that you discuss this with your dermatology team, who will be able to give you much more specific advice. Adalimumab works to slightly suppress the immune system, but it's more specific than other general medications such as methotrexate, which you may have been given before. If you do have problems with recurrent infection, or if you've ever been exposed to tuberculosis in the past, please make sure that you discuss this with your doctor and that they're aware of this before prescribing the medication for you. We also want to know if you have had a diagnosis of the cancer in the past 5 years, or if you suffer from heart failure, as adalimumab might not be suitable for you in these cases. Please tell us if you're pregnant or planning to conceive in the near future, as we may choose a different medication for you if that's possible. Adalimumab is given by injection into the skin, usually every 2 weeks. It will be delivered to your door by home care, which is a company outsourced by the NHS to deliver this medication to you, and they will be responsible for training you how to use it. Before you do start adalimumab, the nurse will show you how to do the injection, and the team at home care will contact you if you run out or before you're running out of injections to arrange another delivery of treatment for you. Although your injections are being delivered to you, it's really important that you attend for your follow-ups in clinic. You'd normally be seen about 3 months after starting treatment, and again, at least once a year after that. We need to see you to assess how well the treatment is working for you, and we would do blood tests at those appointments. If you don't attend for these appointments, then it's likely that your treatment will be stopped, so it's really important that we continue to be able to monitor you. In general, adalimumab works very well and it's very well tolerated, and most people don't get side effects. As with any injection, sometimes people do have a problem with injection site reactions causing redness, itching or bruising, but that should settle within a few days and doesn't normally occur. If side effects do happen, the most common would include headaches or sinusitis. And if you're concerned you have an infection, for example, if you have a temperature, swelling, or if you're feeling particularly unwell, please make sure you get medical advice as soon as possible. If you do have an infection, we recommend delaying your next adalimumab injection and then restarting it again when you feel better, and if you did get any antibiotics, when this treatment has finished. There are other potential side effects with adalimumab, but these are rare, and further information about them can be found in the written information that you will have been given. The link has been given at the end of the video. If you do develop any side effects that you consider significant, even if they're not listed as a potential side effect for adalimumab, please let your team know, and if you're very concerned, then stop the medication. Adalimumab is a fairly safe medication, but we do check your blood tests before you start treatment, and regularly once you're on them. This is largely done to make sure you remain well, rather than expecting to find any problems because of the medication. If you need an operation, then you may need to delay taking your adalimumab, as this could increase the chance of you getting an infection after the operation. Please make sure that you discuss this with your dermatology team, and they will help you work out the time of injection and how to time it around the procedure. Most medications are safe to take with adalimumab. Please make sure that anyone who prescribes for you is aware that you're taking this. There's no interaction between adalimumab and alcohol, but we do recommend keeping your alcohol intake within government recommendations. If you've not yet been given written information about adalimumab, please scan the QR code appearing on your screen now to access this. This information is brought to you by the British Association of Dermatologists. Finally, if you have any other questions, please contact your consultants team directly.